suis trop jeunette pour faire un ami.
Have you ever experienced where you've read a book that's enlightened your mind, or you listened to a podcast, you watched a film that just changed your whole perspective about everything? You feel like smart, clever, intellectually, like stimulated to the point that you want to tell everybody what you've learned. You're looking for that opportunity to say, hey, look at this new thing that's changed my whole thinking. And what can happen is you have this new thinking in your mind, you feel like a different person, and a friend of yours has a problem, and your body says, oh, this is the opportunity, or let's say the ego says, this is your opportunity to share this new information, this new knowledge from the book you've read, or the movie you've watched, or something that you've learned. This is the opportunity in relation to your friend's problem that you can now come in and be the smart, all-knowing, all-powerful person that's going to change their situation. And it makes you feel good knowing that you could possibly do this, right? Because obviously you feel different, you feel good, and you want people to have that same feeling as well. And so your friend has a problem, they come to you, and unfortunately what can happen is that you don't listen. Your friend starts to talk and you're not really listening to your friend. You're looking for that gap, that opportunity to just put what you have learned in their problem, so somehow they can turn around and say, thank you so much, you're so clever, you're so smart, etc. That's kind of like the subtext, I think. Rather than listening, what happens is there's this kind of like frustration. Your friend feels frustrated, your friend feels like you haven't listened to them. You feel that your friend's not listening to you, or that they're stubborn, or they don't want to change. And there's a clash. And the clash is because there's been an assumption, and that assumption is just because something has helped you in a particular moment, you now feel it's going to help someone else in exactly the same way. I'm using this because one thing this residency has reminded me, there is the unknown that's happening when a creative act is happening. And I think it's helped me to be in a state of humility. I think to not have assumption means to go in with an open mind. And just because something has worked for you last time in the studio space, in other words, similar to just because something you have read has helped you, or something you have watched has enlightened your mind, it doesn't now mean that just because it's done, we've done it that way before, that, oh, we're gonna do it this way again. I think it makes the work, keeps the work fresh, it keeps you humble, and it keeps you in this place of always being ready to learn.